The National Science Foundation funds engineering research centers, and the CIST is one of these that focuses on leveraging nanotechnology to build self-powered, wearable, wireless sensors.
It's a health monitoring system, so it could end up being used in the future for patients to monitor their heart when they're having arrhythmias, and it could send out a signal if somebody has a heart issue. I mean, it could end up being a device in the future that ends up saving lives.
We have to come up with solutions to problems that have not been faced before and try to address those. And that's challenging and rewarding at the same time.
The Assist Center spans 4 primary schools, encompasses 30 some odd faculty, and many graduate students and undergraduates who are all working toward a common goal. My group in particular works on building circuits, and we've built a system on chip that is kind of the electronic hub of the sensor nodes that the center is working on.
This is the program that we use to do most of our design work, which is a CAD program called Cadence. Once we're completed with a schematic that represents our entire design, we have to complete something called layout. The layout is actually a representation of what layers of silicon and metal look like. Even though this looks very big on the screen, it's actually just about 4 millimeters by 4 millimeters on each side. So you can kind of imagine when we get this whole thing back, it's very small. It can fit on the tip of your finger.
And the circuits on that system on chip right now are capable of harvesting from solar and from thermoelectric generators, which basically convert the thermal difference between your skin and the air into a small usable voltage.
We want to be able to, pull data from the cloud and look at histories of various.
I think that we will move into a world where technology allows us to acquire information to a degree that we can't even really comprehend at the moment. The only way we can get there is by making big strides above the technology that's available right now. And the Assist Center is trying to make some of those strides. This technology is really critical to achieving the kind of vision that people have for next generation healthcare.